The last thing I had to read was David Graeber. I saw this on Reddit. I think it's from the book Debt. I'm not sure, though. He says, I will define communism here as any human relationship that operates under the principle of from each according to their abilities to each according to their needs. All of us act like communists a good deal of the time. None of us act like a communist consistently. Communist society, in the sense of a society organized exclusively on that single principle, could never exist. But all social systems, even economic systems like capitalism, have always been built on top of a bedrock of actually existing communism. To look past the question of individual or private ownership, which is little more than formal legality anyway, and at a much more immediate and practical questions of who has access to what sorts of things and under what condition. Starting, as I say, from the principle of from each according to their abilities to each according to their needs. Whenever it is the operative principle, even if it's just two people interacting, we can say that we are in the presence of a sort of communism. Almost everyone follows this principle if they are collaborating on some common project. If someone fixing a broken water pipe says, hand me the wrench, his coworker will not, generally speaking, say, and what do I get for it? Even if they are working for ExxonMobil, Burger King, or Goldman Sachs. The reason is simple efficiency, ironically enough, considering the conventional wisdom that communism just doesn't work. If you really care about getting something done, the most efficient way to go about it is obviously to allocate tasks by ability and to give people whatever they need to do them. One might even say that it's one of the scandals of capitalism that most capitalist firms internally operate communistically. True, they don't tend to operate very democratically. Most of them are organized around military-style top-down chains of command. But there is an interesting tension here because top-down chains of command are not particularly efficient. They tend to promote stupidity among those on the top and resentful foot-dragging among those at the bottom. The greater the need to improvise, the more democratic the cooperation tends to become. This is presumably also why, in the immediate wake of great disasters, a flood, a blackout, or an economic collapse, people tend to behave in the same way, reverting to a rough-and-ready kind of communism. However briefly, hierarchies and markets and the like become luxuries that no one can afford. Anyone who has lived through such a moment can speak to their peculiar qualities, the way strangers become brothers and sisters, and human society itself seems to be reborn. This is important because it shows that we are not simply talking about cooperation. In fact, communism is the foundation of all human sociability. It is what makes society possible.
I'm so